is in your workbook, page 4. It says the top exponential growth models. When a real life quantity increases by a fixed percent each year, the amount y of the quantity after t years can be modeled by this equation. You can see that we have y equals a, the initial amount, times 1 plus r, the annual interest rate, close parentheses, raised to t, the number of years after you start. All the variables are listed for you right here. If you recall, 1 plus r is your growth factor. And so when you're given the formula and you're asked to find your annual interest rate, you look at the growth factor and you subtract 1 from it. And that will tell you your growth, your annual interest rate. Now, where it says examples of exponential growth include, it says the base b must be greater than 1. So b is greater than 1 as indicated here. 5 is greater than 1, that's the base here. 1.4 is greater than 1. So they satisfy that requirement. Okay? They're just examples. Now, here's an opportunity for us to fill in some blanks. It says, if y equals 2300 times 1.07 raised to the t, what is the initial amount? Well, the initial amount is the amount times what's in the parentheses. So please fill in 2300 in this blank space. 2300. And then it says, the rate of increase. Okay, the rate of increase would be what you get after you subtract 1 from the growth factor. So this growth factor is 1.07. And when you subtract 1 from that, you get 0.07. That's a 7% annual interest rate, or an annual interest increase. I'm sorry, a rate of increase. Okay? So please put those three numbers where they go. And then let's take a look at what we have below this. Parts A and B. Now, it says, in 1995, the cost of tuition in a state university was $4,300. Since then, the tuition has risen 4% each year. Write a mathematical model that gives the tuition Y in dollars T years after 1995. So what you're supposed to realize is, in 1995, T equals 0. Any year after that, you're going to subtract 1995 from that year to learn what the t value is. Okay, so starting with y equals, the initial amount is the $4,300. Then you've got 1 plus the annual interest rate, or the annual increase. And so it says 4% should be interpreted as a decimal, 0.04. Very good. And then using the formula that they provided up above, you raise that to the t. So that's the formula. In part B, it says, what is the growth factor? We've learned that the growth factor is what's in the parentheses. So the growth factor is 1.04. And when it asked you for the increase, the percent increase, it told us it was 4%. Okay?